Good morning, Compass. I want to share with you a story that may give you some comfort in this time. When I was 4 years old, my mom had this plan to go to the zoo. But it was really, really, really important to her because she was a single mother, really overwhelmed, working too hard. She didn't have enough money to support us. And she said that she felt really guilty because she was always working and not spending enough time with me. So she had this plan to go to the zoo where we'd have this great day. And we'd get there early and we'd be the first ones at the line so we could see all the animals before anyone else and be quiet and nice and special. And so the morning came and she woke me up. And when she woke me up, she tells me how, you know, I was like, I don't want to wake up. Let me stay asleep. And then she wanted to get me dressed and I didn't want to get dressed. I want to go back to bed. Yeah, and then she wanted to give me food to hurry up. It's like, hurry, we got to eat because we got to get to the zoo. We have the plan to get to the zoo. And I was like, I don't want to eat. I'm not even hungry. and then eventually, you know, she gets me in the car, but we're already kind of running behind. And she's kind of racing there with anxiety, like stressed out. Like the plan to get to the zoo and be there for a special day, we're already so far behind. She's stressed out. And we get to the zoo and we get to the parking lot. And the parking lot was already like really, you know, getting to be full. It's like, we missed it. We missed this special time. And we get out and she's like, come on, rush. We have to go faster. We have to go faster to get to the front of the entrance. And I was like going really slow and it gave her more anxiety to go fast. Like, come on, go fast. We have to get there. And then in the middle of the walk to the entrance, she says she just burst out laughing. And the reason she started laughing is she saw me bending over, smelling a rose. And it could not have been a greater sign, you know, stop and smell the roses. That in the midst of all the planning, all the stress, that something so simple, just seeing a rose for me, made it special. And it made it special for her. I'm sharing that with you because in the midst of all the anxiety, all the stress, all the news, all the uncertainty, all the things you can't control, I know that every day there's a rose for each and every one of us. And so I urge you, try to find that rose every single day. Enjoy it. Remember it. It's something we can look back on in the months and years ahead as something that was really, really special. So just stop and smell the roses. Thank you.